Demanding on graphic assuming section.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the Autobahn Motor Car Group Sports Car Challenge, brought to you by the Autobahn Motor Car Group. And today we are racing at Donington. This is a private league that I've joined. I streamed a race 2 weeks ago. Would have been the first race that I would have been in, but it ended up being that we called off the race. We ran the race, but we ran it as a kind of a practice race because we had some issues with setting up the server. So, doesn't appear that we're going to have any issues like that this time. We are 30 minutes about from the start of the race. Qualifying has been going on for almost 4 hours now. The way that we do our races, we have a half an hour practice followed by a 4 hour qualifying and then a 1 hour race. We do have a few 90 minute races, and for those it's a 30 minute practice and then a 4 hour qualify and then the 90 minute race. So anyways, for this one, I'm driving the Cadillac CTS-V race car, as is Jim McInnes, Dave Hill, Billy Smith II, and Sean Phillips. So far in qualifying, I am qualified first in class. We do not separate the classes in this league for the start, because iRacing hasn't worked out yet how to separate individual classes with multiple cars in each class. And in this case, we have both the BMW Z4 and the Porsche Rough Track are both in the same class, and because of that, we have to separate all five cars into five classes, and so we just start them all together. So, anyways, I'm gonna let you guys listen in as we finish up qualifying, and then we'll run the race in about half an hour. I haven't actually run one of these races other than the one 2 weeks ago at Bathurst that we didn't end up using as an official race. So I think that Sean Phillips here and Billy Smith II are going to end up being my main competition. Although I say that, and both of them are qualified in the last two spots.
Give me a chance here.
Track's getting a bit busy. My setup with cold tires has basically no grip at all.
Sorry, Robert, I was on the wrong channel.
It's no big deal, man, just a hot lap. Qualify sessions. HPD is just getting away.
That's why he made them so long, so everyone would have an opportunity to get a good lap in a couple hours, regardless of all the classes being up there.
No, I appreciate that. It's just, I was on a killer lap there and got cut off. Yeah, we can do killer laps consistently, but when you're on the hot lap, it's kind of eh.
Yeah, I hear you.
It's hard to get back in the rhythm, you know? The earlier you show up, the lighter the traffic.
I'm a white boy, I got no rhythm.
Thank you.
Looks like we're going to have a small turnout.
Going down with you. I'm in the race. Oh,
shit.
Wait,
I'll go. That's all good. That's funny. It's 0X. I didn't feel anything.
Well, we got the usual three horses. That's all there ever has been, I think. I think there's more than three horses.
I seem to remember there being more early on, but it seems like on every league, as the season rolls on, a lot of guys real life gets in the way, they drop into or something. But the just space really dwindles in most leagues as the season goes on.
Our attendance has stayed pretty consistent. I think our low has been 28 and our high is 34. I have a feeling tonight's going to be our new low, though.
Yeah, this is another league I run. Matter of fact, Leaf, I meant to tell you, that one league, I didn't even want to be there. I wasn't feeling good. I lost it like on lap one, and I didn't even bother trying to correct it. Good, I'm out. I can go to bed. But that one was at VIR, and that league was, what did we see, like 30-some people at Daytona, and it must have been like 10 in the race we had the other night at VIR.
Lap there. Just ran a little too wide. Matter of fact, I'm gonna get out of John's way here.
Holy smokers, we're beating the DPs. That's not surprising anybody. I don't know why I'm surprised by that.
This car is so loud, I feel like I need to do something to turn up the sound on the voice chat. I can't actually turn it up. I have to turn engine noise down a little bit.
Here we are again, within a few tenths of each other.
Also going to do something to try and get a little bit more stable frame rate. I feel like it's stuttering.
Oh, you're right,
John.
Hell,
so
I was trying to follow you and find out where all your braking points were and everything. It's going to be very, very difficult to pass you if you didn't want that. That's for sure.
There's something I don't need. Cockpit mirrors. That should make a big difference, actually. There's those slick tires I was telling you about. Cold tires are just so slippery. It's gonna be interesting in the race when that happens. Speaking of the race, I think I'm going to try take a practice pit stop or two, just because I haven't done that yet, and I don't know exactly where the pit entrance is. But this being an hour race, I'm going to definitely need pit stop for fuel. We run in this league, we run 60% fuel max for all cars. So I think the Cadillac can usually take 22 gallons or 23 gallons maybe. But for these league races, it can only be 14.5. Okay, well, that's a pretty simple pit entrance. Much easier than Bathurst. Helps if you put it in gear. I was wondering why I wasn't going. Oh, I lied, we can only take 14.3 gallons of fuel. Not 14.5. And actually, I might as well at this point just go ahead and put my fuel in for the race. Do a couple of practice laps with full fuel. So there is actual prize money for each of these races for the Autobahn Motorcar Group Sports Car Challenge. Each of the class winners gets $5 in iRacing credits. The cleanest driver, which is calculated by number of incidents divided by number of laps completed. Actually, I think it's the other way around. Number of laps completed divided by number of incidents. Anyways, cleanest driver also gets $10. At the season conclusion, the class winners each get, I believe it's $20 in iRacing credits. And each team, there's a team championship that's going along with this. Each team, the team winners gets $20 for each member on the team, I think. Don't quote me on those numbers. We usually do one fast repair on the races. This week there's going to be two fast repairs because of the short length of the track. I think that the we'll call him the administrator of the league, John Ulmer, decided that because he thought that the track was such a short track, he was expecting a bigger crowd, I think, than what we have. I think he was expecting that people would be needing a second fast repair. I'm not sure the way that the points all work out for the league, but I do know that the winner, class winner, gets 25 points. Second gets 22, and I believe third gets 20. Pole sitter also gets a bonus point. So at the moment, that would be me for this class. Not that the points really mean anything to me this season, because there's only 4 races left, and even before this race, I was already mathematically out of the running for the points championship. I do plan on running the full second season of this league. Christopher Sherburn showed up. Got another Cadillac in here. It's good to see. He apparently doesn't know which way the track goes yet.
Can I get a mic check?
Clear.
Gotcha. Looks like Billy Smith II has gone to second place in class for qualifying. 105.281. About 15 minutes left in qualifying.
Thank you.
this feels pretty good. I'm not really even trying all that hard, and I am in race setup, and I'm doing times that are still just as fast, if not faster, than most of the other cars in my class. Than their qualifying times, I should say. Oops.
Right side. Clear on the right. They say you cut the course. You'll have to slow down and give up the time gained.
Well, it's frame rate. I'm cold tired, Sam. Go back.
Left side. Clear.
Just about 10 minutes left in qualifying here. A little less than that. Sean Phillips has dropped to 6th in the Cadillac class. That actually has me curious, because I would have expected him to be faster than that. Christopher Sherburn was the guy that I said looked like he didn't know his way around the track. He apparently figured it out.
I'm on a flyer, Sean, if you can help me out.
I think I'm going to go into the pits here. Actually, I'm going to take one more lap.
Left side. Clear.
Braking for that corner and then exiting the corner, back end definitely seemed to have less grip than it had the previous few laps, few corners. I wonder if I overcooked the tires a little bit exiting the chicane and it just found its way into it, having less grip for the first corner there. That'll be something I'll be looking to not repeat during the race. So, I think real quick, I'm going to go join the team speak for these Autobahn sessions. See if my team is around.
Okay, I'm starting to grasp the fact that I have my own cards here that I'm playing.
Is channel it- switched.
Hello.
Hello. Who do we have here?
This is Danny.
Oh, hey Danny, how's it going?
Good. Got the live stream going.
Excellent. Hello, everybody.
How's your qualifying going?
It's probably about as good as I'm going to get it for tonight.
Are you on track?
What's up?
Are you on track?
No, not right now.
Oh, okay.
Looks like you're all set to dominate the GTD again.
Let's hope.
At least some of the GTLMs got past you this time.
Yeah.
For now.
Yeah, I was just doing a bunch of practice laps and race trim. Which, I say race trim, I just added fuel is all.
Yeah.
But I was still doing mid to high 104s.
Been having any graphics problems in turn one?
Not really. I did turn my graphics out settings down just a little bit anyway because everybody else was having problems. I didn't want it to sneak up on me during the race.
Good thinking.
I don't know if this is the case for you, but in the Cadillac, and it sounds like in the Daytona prototype as well, on cold tires, there's absolutely zero grip.
I have heard that. I'm going to watch out for everybody on the first couple laps for that. Seems like the GTLMs are sticking pretty well.
Okay.
Definitely
I was able to
much
get
different ride, but it still sticks.
Okay. I was able to get my setup set in such a way that I could get a fair amount of grip on my old lap and my first qualifying lap, but by the end of that first hot lap, the tires were already pretty much cooked, and then from there on, it had just massive understeer.
Mm.
Yeah, I've just watched three different drivers in the Cadillac go off while exiting the pits because of cold tires.
Don't forget your race fuel.
Yep, already there.
Did.
All right, well, I'm actually going to back out of here again. I just want to see who was here. I'm going to run my stream during the race.
All right, good luck.
Right. Yep, talk to you maybe after the race.
See you after the race.
All right, bye. Disconnected. Well, there we go. Just about ready for the race now. Looks like John's gonna get one more hot lap. Oh, nope, then we're still in replay, so no, he's not getting a hot lap. Especially when he spins out like that. So, there it is, the chance ending his qualifying run, qualifying session's over, and I did get the bowl from my class, so got the bonus point. And Mark Schindel joined up just in time for the race, it looks like. We've got a couple of people that aren't actually here. They're going to miss the start, including Billy.
All right, there's the chicken flag.
There, he's coming back. So we'll have 7 Cadillacs this race. Make sure I do have proper amount of fuel. I do.
One lap to green. Line up on the left side. Pit road is closed.
So, I am starting in amongst the GTLM cars, the Porsches and the BMWs. The classes, okay, I don't know if I described this in the last video or not, but the classes that we have for this league, the P1 class is the HPD, the P2 class is the Daytona prototype, the GTLM class is the Porsches and the BMWs, and the GTD class is the Cadillacs.
Alright guys, this is survival of the fittest. It's like the zombie apocalypse on a racetrack.
Perfect. Thank you.
Well, we don't have a very big field tonight, so I think we should have a pretty easy time picking our way through traffic. And just kind of taking her easy, because this track will bite you quick, as you've all found out in practice.
Yep. We're not on a standing start, are we?
No, we are not. I figured out what happens. Anytime I go into the league session, it resets it back to standing start, because I keep having to go back and change it. I had to change it 3 different times back to rolling start.
Weird. Isn't there a thing there where you can save the setting or whatever? I'm not familiar with it.
Yeah, you can click to use last settings or something like that, but the problem is I have to change things for each track, and so it automatically reverts it back to standing start at that point.
You were
rolling. Oh, I gotcha. Okay.
Well, I was hoping that we'd have a
good
full
luck, everyone. Everybody,
pacing lap.
You know, just
instead
your line,
of just a
be
half
careful.
A lap. But
HPDs, be real mindful of the GT and the DPs, because it's going to be real tough picking your way through here.
Be careful of the cold tires.
Looks like
ready.
You missed the start, but I don't think it's a big deal on this track.
Yeah, not yet. Minutes left to get on.
The pace car is in. Green, green, green.
Cold tires. Boy, Jim McManus made a fantastic start to get up to second place in Cadillac GTD class. Only a second behind me. As of yet, I have no reason to try and pass Brandon here, so I'm just gonna stick him behind him.
Thank you.
sorry about that, Sean. Really wasn't expecting you to be on the brakes quite that early.
No problem, man.
Forgot to downshift the second time.
Take the inside up here, Chuck. Go right.
Oof. I am losing the front end. Coming out of that corner every lap.
Thank you.
That time I got on the outside of the curbing. It caused me to lose the back end just a little bit.
What you buy on the back straight, Billy?
Go right, Kevin.
Thank you.
Car on your left. Clear on the left.
Thank you.
I have a feeling the wind direction has changed. And it's pushing me down into that corner, because even that time I approached it slowly and I still felt like I ended up going a little deeper than I wanted to.
Go left.
Fucking stutter.
Thank you.
Right side. Clear on the right.
go right there, Ross, all that up. Go left, go left, go left, go left.
I could probably go past Brandon now, but again, I have no reason to try and force the issue, so I won't. Ross blinked there. I didn't know where he went.
Thank you.
Douglas has got to be more patient than he was there. He tried to force the car where there wasn't room. Something for me to keep in mind for the future. Watch out for him when he comes up again. Make sure he's not going to squeeze me somewhere.
Right.
Definitely went too far into the braking zone that time.
Go left.
Thank you. Go right, Douglas.
Well, Brandon here just suddenly upped his pace.
Wait for the main straight, John, if you can.
Left side.
Go right.
Clear on the left.
So I decided to try and do the pass there because I had a good run. He didn't have anybody in front of him, and because Daniel, behind me, was looking awfully racy, and I did not want to have him try to get by me in order to get to Brandon and have it screw up my race. And now I just need to shut up and get a move on. Because as soon as I did that, I kind of slowed up a bit.
John, your comms are off. Back, pavement.
Not many opportunities this track to reach over and grab a drink. Well, despite letting John Ulmer by in the HPD, that was my best lap of the race.
Okay.
Don't do that.
Car right. Clear on the right.
I can just as easily go around the outside of you back there, so just stay on your line. Whenever, John, I don't want to be holding you up.
Thank you.
Painless boat.
Daniel must have had something happen to him because he dropped back about 6 seconds.
Hey, Robert.
You're not. 93.
to hit that yellow.
Thanks, Kevin, for waiting.
Yeah, no problem.
Looks like I will need a full fuel stop. Full for this league anyways. 14.3 gallons.
God damn, dude, sorry.
I had the brakes locked up, I couldn't slow down.
That's what it's on the inside here.
Right side. Clear.
Thank you.
Whenever an HPD comes right back in front of me like that, before we go into a braking zone, I just get just a little bit nervous, thinking that they may brake at the same point that I usually brake,
go right,
and they can stop up so much quicker than I can. I get a little bit nervous that they'll stop suddenly and I won't be able to stop behind them.
Thank you, Robert.
Managed to pull out 10 seconds, just about 10 seconds, on Jim McInnes. Most of that has been since I got past Brandon. I think he and I were actually slowing each other up, because I was getting up in his mirror and making him miss braking points and such. Now that I'm ahead of him, he's able to run cleaner laps.
Right side chance, I'll stay well.
Thank you, Lee.
job, Doug. That was the basement, Jim. I didn't mean to do that, but otherwise I was going to flip Daniel.
Go right down the hill when we get down here, Kevin. Go right, go right, go right.
Sorry, I thought you meant after that right hand.
Right side, clear on the right.
Jim, I went to file in back behind you, but I noticed Daniel closing a little bit too fast, so I had to go back to the inside.
That car's a letdown.
The car in front of me is Christopher Sherburn, fifth place in the GTD class. At some point, I lapped Sean Phillips. He must have been in the pits at the time.
Sorry for the scare there, John.
Clear on the right.
There again, second time that I've seen Douglas do that.
Sorry.
Second time Douglas has gone by, so the second time I've seen him force a car where it shouldn't go.
Right inside.
That was...
Left side. Clear.
Didn't realize Robert was talking to me. But anyways, that was not the smartest place. Douglas to try and go past me.
Car right. Clear. The lead is pitting now. You got about 2 laps of fuel.
I'm gonna wait one more lap, at least, before I pit. It'll depend on how much fuel I have left at the end of the lap. Looks like I should be good for one more lap after this one. I will pit right now.
Well, I put in two quick repairs for this race, and nobody's even needed any.
Again, it's spitting out. Don't jinx this, John.
My head's made of wood, don't worry.
It's almost too fast entering there.
Hardwood.
Ooh, halfway.
Sitting out.
Go inside.
Cold tires again, so I gotta be really careful and tiptoe around this first lap.
Sorry, bro, I didn't mean to do that. I just was trying to sneak around the inside. It was unintentional.
Leaf, I'm pitting this lap.
Okay.
Car right.
I'm pitting this time, and guys, watch out, this team.
Tires are starting to come up to temperature. I'm already starting to feel
sorry, Brandon,
a bit more grip.
I didn't expect Christopher to try to let me through. I was going to open a pile in between y'all.
Oh, no worries.
Ooh, I can't believe I saved that.
Yeah, I actually wasn't intending.
Yes, I don't have quite as much grip yet as I thought.
Just, like, exit stage left.
Oh, nah, I was just going to follow you.
Pitting out, guys. Pitting out.
Too busy thinking about the fact that I wasn't going to have deal with Douglas passing me again. At least not that round of pit stops, anyway.
Go around me here. I left my rev limiter on. Sorry.
Putting out.
Still waiting for the tires to fill.
I
feel 100% comfortable. They're still not quite there. Got about 30 seconds though on Jim McInnes.
You're in the top 10.
And apparently I'm in the top 10 overall. Which I think I was before the pit stops anyway.
Come on, man, just hold your line.
Thanks, Christopher.
No problem.
Something like that when we got turned back off.
Exiting pit.
Exiting pit.
go right under braking here at the bottom of the hill, Russ.
Well, so far, hopefully I'm not going to jinx it by saying this, but so far I've run a clean race.
Shit, sorry about the scare.
No, that was awesome. Nice drift.
Wish I could say it was intentional.
Excellent pass, Tim.
Come on by, Matt.
Thank you.
Car right.
Go, Chad.
Clear on the right.
Sorry, John.
No, you did everything right.
Thank you.
Kind of thought I did everything right, but he went off, so I figured, well, maybe I should apologize anyway. Apparently I am 8th overall. Here comes Douglas again. This is the one that makes me a bit nervous. He's got a much clearer shot at the turn though this time.
Car right, clear.
That was a much better run for him.
Sorry, Brandon, that was a little late.
No problem.
Thank you.
Going right, Billy.
Go around,
Slow around me,
Daniel.
Slow around me, Daniel.
Thank you.
Perfect.
Right side. Clear.
Robert, Jim, I'll let both of you guys go on the right-hand side here. Go right.
Thank you, Matt.
John, you as well. Thank you, Matt.
About 18 minutes left to go in the race. Haven't had much to say, just kind of turning laps. Got a quite sizable lead on second place. Not really pushing all that hard, just trying to get it to the end.
Clear on the right.
If anybody sees my rhythm on the track, you want to send it back my way? Not until I find mine.
Yeah, I think it fucked off with mine.
Probably should have changed tires and stuff, but that's too late now, I think.
Probably have another 10 or 12 laps on them, so good luck with that.
Nah, no, I'm good.
Go right, Douglas.
Okay, gotcha. That's it, Kevin. Keep going, keep going. That's not.
With the amount of clean laps that I'm putting in, I wish this was an official iRacing race.
Damn,
getting a ton of safety ratings.
Y'all good, Daniel?
Yeah, I had to get back some time.
Oh yeah, it's gonna happen. I had to do this. Go left, Kevin.
I
that was almost race over.
Damn it, Ross, I'm sorry, man. I geared right, I couldn't slow down.
Couldn't tell what Ross was doing in the sand over there, if he was going to come back out on track.
Is your car okay? Can you continue?
Don't forget, y'all have two fast repairs.
Hey, John, I see you coming. Go on, bud.
Hey, thanks, Matt.
Ross is blinking behind me again.
Car right. Clear. Left side, clear.
In front. There's quite a gaggle of cars right in front of me here.
Stay right out of the corner, please.
That car's a lap down.
Come on by, John.
Thank you.
I was gonna say that they include second place. Well, I guess it would only be the second place Porsche or BMW, I'm not sure which one it is. Not necessarily second place in the class, because again, the Porsches and the BMWs are in the same class, but they're not shown in the same class on iRacing here.
Hey Danny, I got damage. I'm gonna let you by.
Car right.
Thank you.
Clear.
Right side, Ross.
Just don't learn.
Anyways, what I was going to say about the second place Porsche or BMW, whichever it is, I guess it's a Porsche. That he's on the same lap as I am, so that's actually a position in the overall standings if I were to get past him. Not that I give a damn about the overall standings. But immediately in front of me, also in a Porsche, is my teammate, David Henry. That's who we were speaking to momentarily before the race. Looks like his race could have gone better.
Wait to the bottom of the hill if you can, John.
What's that?
That car's a lap down.
Nah, it's too easy to pass on the outside right there.
For you?
It's an inside,
yeah. Yeah, we have to switch down for us. We can just drive around the outside of that off-camber turn. Makes it easy. Y'all have to hug it tight, and we can go wide, so we don't ever even get cross paths down there.
It's the me hugging it tight part that I don't like.
right side. Clear.
Thank you.
Go inside, John.
Got Douglas coming up on me again.
Yeah, this truck is a fuel burner, man. I'm wondering if I'm gonna make it.
He almost ran into me too. Ugh. That's making me very nervous. I'm just gonna let these guys by.
Left side, clear on the left.
Minutes and 40 seconds left.
Keep it coming, Ralph.
I should have plenty of fuel.
And totally loses the front end when you get behind something.
That car's a lap down.
Sorry, Danny. Go by.
Right side.
That's no problem.
Clear.
Okay, guys, go ahead.
Thanks. I was just trying to lift up
the almost lost the back end there.
Inside on exit, though. Do it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Keep coming, Douglas. Okay.
Yep.
Less than 5 minutes left. I should have 5 laps left. It's possible I could have 6, although highly unlikely.
Got 4 minutes left, guys.
John is wanting me to pass? No, he's not. That's...
I'm just cruising about it, don't worry about me back here behind me.
Forgot who it was that's in front of me.
Right there.
Left side.
No, Leaf is gonna let me pass, though.
Clear.
Thanks.
That was a close side look.
Right side. Clear.
Had not fully intended to let those guys by, but...
Come on by, Kevin.
When I almost lost the back end... at the beginning of my exit...
You got about 5 laps of fuel left.
Figured discretion's the better part of valor. Back out, stay over the outside, let these guys by. Should have 2 laps left. Unless something horrendous happens to John.
I'm not gonna be there by then. Thank God for the white flag. I've been running fuel map 3 the entire second stint, and I'm just barely gonna make it.
Oh wow, see, I saw you two nose to tail. I thought you were race for position, and I was just trying to get the hell out of your way.
Yeah,
that's
what I thought.
Yeah,
I was hoping you were going to run out of fuel. Yeah, I think I've finally learned to stop doing that.
Just the chicane to go.
You got a slow car on the right.
Yeah, yeah, I don't think the HPD can make it on map 8 all the way through.
They run out.
You have about 2 laps of fuel left.
You said you did or you didn't?
Get in.
Robert, if you guys are still out there, give us a push.
Alright, there's the chicken flag.
Well,
great job, you did really well.
Not a bad way to have my first race in the league. Only wound up, I think, about 5 or 6 seconds slower than the only non-HPD.
Hey, Rockman, I'm sorry
again
for knocking you off, man.
I did okay for hitting twice. Stupid pit lander turned off on me on exit.
so I have another 15 seconds stop and go.
Man, you must have been channeling me on that one then. That's usually me that makes those kind of errors.
I had the same thing happen, but I had my pit limiter on. I was just going a little too fast for it to slow me down at the time.
Yeah, I was being smart, man. I took one pit stop, gonna splash of fuel and no tires, and it was just beautiful. And then it's like, no, you speed it out of the pit lane. Oh, man.
Yeah, Robert, the only reason I took tires is because I looked at when Leaf came out of the pits, and I knew he didn't take tires. So if I would have taken tires, I would have been probably right behind him. So I didn't take any either.
I still wouldn't have beat you.
I was suffering for it, and I was right behind Leaf, but then this 15-second penalty, and it's just like, man, are you serious?
Okay, the race is over. Bring it on in.
Okay, you kept close enough on me, and then you get traffic, and then you get something.
Oh, it's ridiculous, man. I mean, it's good fun, but it's just really hard.
Yeah, thanks for the race, everyone. I gotta jump off. I got a sister coming over. Today's my birthday. Go ahead.
Happy birthday.
You want us to sing?
I want to hear you sing, Robert. Come on, buddy.
No, you gotta get me liquored up first.
Yeah, I was just searching for the mute button. Happy birthday, by the way. Hey, everybody, I'm proud of everyone. This was a good race, very clean, and this track is tough. It's especially tough for you guys who are driving nose to tail a lot, because it is a damn difficult track to follow somebody on because of the elevation changes. It makes it so easy to hit the back of them when you're just trying to follow them. So I think everybody did a damn good job.
Yeah, it was awesome. I loved it. I just, stupid mistakes on my part.
Well, that was a lot of fun.
Good job, Danny. I had one X until the last 10 minutes, and I just started racking them all up. I could not seem to stay on the track after that.
Yeah, good job, guys. I don't know if I had any either. I don't know. Let's see. But anyway, I'm out of here. Thanks, guys. We'll see you next time.
See you, John. Yeah, I grabbed a few of them, taking evasive action, just because I got a little closer than I thought I was going to people, so rather than hit them, I just...
Well,
I have 24
overall.
X's.
Seventh overall for the race.
Where did all
race?
The DP go? There was only ended up being two of us. I'm glad I got a win, but it's kind of less exciting when it's only...
So, I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, make sure you click on the like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and until next time, I will see you next time.